So welcome to this next video on using Latex. So in my previous video, we looked at the general basics and guidelines on using Latex and Overleaf in generating an example of a manuscript. So in this session, we are going to look at really how can we convert the Overleaf project into an offline version to work on it on the desktop. Now, this is very important because sometimes you always work without internet. And when you don't have internet, you will not be able to access Overleaf or use Overleaf offline. The next reason is when you're using the free version of Overleaf, there's always a limit on the number of times you can compile your document. So when you reach beyond this limit, you cannot compile your document further. So it is always important to learn the skills of, you know, using the offline version of Latex. Unless you actually do the upgrade, there's upgrading option for Overleaf where you can increase the number of limits you have to compile your document. So first of all, let's look at how to download this Overleaf project. So we are going to go one step backwards, okay? When you go one step backward, you will see this page where you have the title of all the projects you are doing. And for this case, we are going to select the first project because it is the one we want to download. When you click or when you tick on this box, you will see a pop-up on this section, the right section, and with one of the options to download this project. So if you want to download, you just click on download, okay? And that project will download from that point. So we can go and check if the project has really downloaded. So the Overleaf project will always download in form of a zip file. And we now extract all the files within the document downloaded. So let's check the download here. So we are going to look at the downloads. And so this is the Overleaf project that has just been downloaded. So let's select it and then extract all. So let's just use the default folders to save the extracted documents. But if you want to store this project elsewhere, you can browse here, this section, and select which section you want to save. But let's use the default one. So after you've selected the folder, you click on extract, okay? So let's check. So you can see here we have the folder called Overleaf Project. So this folder, let's inspect the files that contains. So it's still a zip file. So let's extract this. So we're just going to use the default. Okay, so you can look at this file, the files in this folder, and you will realize that all the files that were there in Overleaf are the same files that are contained in this section. So the next thing now is to download and set up the Miktex, which is the version for, which is a software for running Latex in desktop. So when we talk about Miktex, this is a software system that will need to compile the Latex document offline within the desktop or even in your laptop. So to download Miktex, let's just quickly Google on Miktex. Now, the beauty with Miktex is that when you download the Miktex, it comes integrated with the packages and tools required to compile the a LaTeX document. Now, in addition to MakeTeX, remember MakeTeX is just a backend, or it's a backend system, but you need additional software for the front end for you as a user to utilize as a text editor when you want to compile the document. Now, the beauty with MakeTeX is that when you download it, it comes with one of the editors already integrated, that is TextWorks, okay? So we are going to see how to install this MakeTeX, and it will also install the integrated TextWorks. So you can say, let's say, getting MakeTeX, okay? So if you scroll down here, you see you can install MakeTeX based on the operating system you're using. So for us, we are using Windows, so that is why it is automatically selected. But if you have these other operating systems, you can also download them. So we are going to download the MakeTeX now. So after you've downloaded the MakeTeX installer, so you are going to just click on it and then complete the download process until the software is installed. So you're going to accept. So you are going to click on this next until you install the version of these MakeTeX. So always just use the default setup until you install the software. So after you've completed your installation, okay, now let's check if the text editor is installed. So you can come to this section of the start icon, and then let's check on, yeah, so you can see, just start typing T and this option comes. So this is the editor that has been automatically been installed. So you're going to click on that TextWorks and open it, okay? So you just say TextWorks, and then you come here to open the TextWork, okay? After you open the TextWork, we are going to see now how do you use that editor to compile the LaTeX document. So after you open up the TextWorks, if you look at these icons down here, you will see the icon here is open, so it will pop up. So this is now the editor called TextWorks. And what I want you to take note of here is just this file section, okay? So if you want to open the file, we want to navigate to the folder of the project that we downloaded from Overleaf and just do a simple compilation. So you come here to files, okay? After you have come here to file, you are going to say open, select open option. So we want to navigate to that folder. So you go to downloads, okay? And then you're going to Overleaf projects. Then, so the thing you need to note here is that this editor, it will only show you the option for files that end with .tex or .tex, okay? Remember when we were looking at the Overleaf, we said that is the main document that will be subjected to compilation. So it's automatically selected. So if you click on this main.tex file, you click on open, okay? So you can see here, the file has been uploaded in our editor. So you can do any editing you want at this section. But let's see, how do you compile this document? So after you've made your edits, now for you to compile, you are going to use this rectangle icon that is highlighted in green. So you click on it, okay? Now, it is important to note that when you download the Miktex, sometimes there are packages that might not be installed, but your document requires that. So in that case, during compilation, you will see a pop-up at a section in this screen that tells you to download that specific software, okay? So if that option pops up, then you are going to click install and then install that software. So it takes some time. Yeah, it has come up now. So you can see just the same as Overleaf. So on our left-hand side, we have the editor where you can actually edit your file. And on the right section, you have your compiled document, okay? So that is generally how you do the compilation. Remember, you can start this project from scratch instead of downloading the one from Overleaf. You can just create a folder and write a .tex file. And within that, you can actually write a simple code for a manuscript, for instance. So I hope you've enjoyed this session, and see you in the next video. Thank you.